Then you'd fill it all up with the apple pumice, fold it up, pull your square up, put those wooden, you know, bits of stick on the top, put your square back down on there, put another cloth on, and then start building again.
Right.
Each one is called a cake. We go 10 cakes high. It's more apparent when you empty it out, because once it's squashed, it looks like cake.
Right.
That's where it gets its name from, I believe, anyway. So when you get to the top 10 cakes high, you're fighting with it, trying to keep it sort of fairly level. And then you throw the follower up on. Now, originally this was 30 hundredweight, 10 and a half. And we've got the large follower over there. Because when I came down, there was old Frank Naish struggling. They were near in their 80s, late 70s, these two old boys. Big wooden square board
yes.
there. So I made one, I built one over there then. And on the forge, I made the little iron handles for putting the blocks in. Anyway, that goes up on there, and then you start winding the press down.
That's a hell of a lot of press,
isn't it? And then it's double screw. So, and once you get a pressure on there, you take it on down, watching it all the time. Too much pressure, it could blister out, fall over, and everything. Well, we've had them fall out. And then go over it later on. You go over to this big cast iron bar over there against the wall.
Yeah.
And you start. You know, you put them down, you just put the press down, that's what they were saying. Then, meantime though, you've got to be baling, when I came here, they were baling them out by hand, three. You've got two trolleys in there. While you were building one cheese, you'll be pressing the other.
Yes.
You want, well, three men, but four is better. There used to be about four of them, but there was Frank Harold, his father, and there was somebody else who used to help him make cider. And in their day, they made 28,000 gallons on this farm from this press.
From
28,000, yeah, in 1 year.
Oh, no.
What you've got is runs off of hydraulic water. You've still got your pump in the background there. Run the line shaft. Still all working
Whoa.
There. That. And you'd be pumping the water, the pressure. And then you'd have a, it's gone like concrete now, this rubber pipe. Attached to there, as the bed's coming up, the ram pushing it up, you'd have your reciprocating pump going, which runs off the line shaft, and that'll pump the cider then on out to the barrels, is what they used to do in 1919. You've got, let me see, oak barrels, the long ones, the stumpy ones are chestnut. I don't think it makes a lot of difference. I don't think so anyway. That particular one there with the X on it, red X, that would have come from Freddie Bennett's Anglo Cider Mills. That finished at the back end of World War II. His daughter decided to go off to America, get married, American and that, and she did all the administration and it sort of put him down and he just left the cider industry and that's it. And of course they were friends with the Naishes, because they were both big cider producers. And ended up with some of their barrels. I bought some of their barrels off them. But I've only got two of them left now, I think, over the years. A bit more stronger, it's about 82.
Have you seen it?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that cut. Proper cut.
Different types of vinaigrette, he said. So it's because cider is more acidic and dry. It's like wine. This is wine.
Our Somerset apple wine.
Right.
Oh, birds.
Leave them out, Paul, because I shall want some in a minute. Let me come and get sorted out first.
Oh, a lovely day out there. Weather wise, isn't it? Made by it's called a squeeze box. It's made by Good Nature. The Buffalo, just outside of New York. Anyway, we imported it right when the money was at its best.
Yeah.
You know, about 4 or 5 years ago. You know, the sterling pound and the dollar and all the rest of it. Basically, what you've got, this is usually folded back over. I've been doing some maintenance. I've got to take the bags out and clean it all down. So where we had the other one, you're building the cheese, You've got the apples coming in here, being washed, going up in the elevator, down through the mill,
yeah.
The scratter. And then instead of shoveling, we use a mono pump. And we pump then, the pumice, this is up over here, into the bag.
Yeah.
So there are your cakes. Exactly the same, you're building a cheese, but sideways. Hit a button, that squashes up, cider drops down into there. And usually I've got another container there in this pump, and that's just pumped off then into the barrels. You've got to watch all this going on, you're running literally on your own doing all this.
Yeah.
Now this one obviously is over here, he's gone pressed up, so you fill this side up, hit another button, 2.5 minutes, he's back there again, pressed. This is then opened up, been squashed, and then you break the cake away with this coracle paddle, away from the side of the bag. Hit another button and that dumps just like it is, that's in the dump position. And I just shovel that into these big dumpy bags. Then that would go on for farmers, or I've just put a load out on the garden now to grow gribbles. So that's for grafting all our rootstocks and stuff. This press, unlike the roller presses aren't a bit inefficient really, especially with rotted or frosted apple. They're nearly impossible. And they also crep the pips,
right.
Most of the pips, making them useless for, obviously, for growing gribbles and that, or your rootstock, and also releasing cyanide into the cider. It's only small amounts, but our press don't do that, and it's really based like a traditional one. In fact, we did a trial, with a racking cloth over there, we did 2 barrels, and then we went on the fill up, and our customers reckon it's improved cider, because the speed of this is 2.5 months over there, feeds every day to fill 1,500 gallons, roughly. Do your exemption. On here, I can do the same in 4.5 days, quite easy. But it's obviously, you won't do it in 4.5 days, because you've got a different the season with apples. It lasts a long time when they drop, and getting them together and, you know, and picking them all up to get them here. It's not that easy. So that's and this is the most modern, this is hydraulic oil, whereas the other one was hydraulic water.
Yeah.
To take note, the water press was slightly more efficient than this one.
Really?
In 1873, yeah. They were more efficient than the modern press. But there you are, there's only 3 in the country, we believe. There's one up at a college up near Hereford. Well, I don't know if it's something to do with Bomers, where they teach people, there's a college somewhere, and they got one. There's one in New Forest Cider, he's got one, we've got one. There's a larger one, the FX280, which is Whitehead Cider at Alton, and he's got the largest one.
Alton in Hampshire?
Yeah, so you've got another cider producer with them. But that's the only one. There were talk of a Welsh cider firm getting one, and I think we're helping them, sending them information. Whether they went on and did, I don't know. And somebody else in Somerset were, but they never came back on it. But